Storm Shield Forecast with NBC 26 Chief Meteorologist Cameron Moreland.
High temperatures this afternoon. We're in the mid to upper 40s. That's exactly where we should be for this time of year. Our normal high today is 47. By the end of the month, our normal high temperature climbs up into the 60s, but we typically don't have to wait that long to see high temperatures in the 60s. As a matter of fact, as you look at the next 7 days, there's going to be several opportunities to see high temperatures around 60 degrees or above. Most days will feature highs in the 50s to around 60 degrees. Right now, we've got a couple of spots that are in the lower 50s. Those spots are north and west of the Fox Valley. From the Fox Valley towards the lakeshore, temperatures are currently in the 40s. In Appleton, it's been a mainly cloudy day, but we're finally starting to break into some sunshine. The temperature is 46 degrees. In Green Bay, after morning clouds, we saw a decent amount of sunshine for much of the afternoon. Just recently, a few clouds have started to move back in from the south. Temperatures are currently in the upper 40s. Dry conditions across northeast Wisconsin today, even with all the clouds. We have high pressure located directly overhead. It'll be our main weather maker for tonight and for most of tomorrow. Then our next bigger weather maker arrives as we head into tomorrow night and Thursday. And south of that system today, it was feeling like mid-spring. Temperatures were in the 60s and 70s, and that warmth is going to be building north and east. Now, speaking of 60s, April is the month that we typically see our first 60s of the year. Last year, it occurred on April 7th. The year before that, we had our first 60 on April 23rd. What's going to happen this year? Well, tomorrow, some spots will get awfully close to 60 degrees, especially west and southwest of the Fox Valley. Across the Fox Valley, look for highs mainly in the mid-50s. Closer to Lake Michigan, temperatures will be in the 30s and 40s, depending on how close you live to Lake Michigan with easterly winds. Tomorrow will feature lots of sunshine after some morning fog. And then for Friday, look for a mixture of a lot of clouds and a little bit of sunshine with some late-day showers developing. But ahead of those showers, it looks like most of us will see high temperatures right around 60 degrees. Most of us would be locations away from Lake Michigan. It's that time of year, cooler by the lake. All right, your forecast for tonight calls for areas of fog developing after midnight. In a few spots, the fog could be locally dense. It's also going to be frosty tomorrow morning with lows in the upper 20s to lower 30s. Tomorrow, plenty of sunshine after some of that morning fog, and very nice. Look at that high, 55 degrees. We'll see even warmer temperatures on Friday, although Friday is probably going to end up being mostly cloudy, and we'll have that chance for some showers, especially by the late afternoon and early evening. That's with a cold front. Behind the cold front, we'll cool down a bit on Saturday. We'll see morning clouds give way to sun and clouds by the afternoon. Temperatures will be in the mid-50s. Sunday looks great, mid to upper 50s with lots of sunshine, and then we will start to warm up again as we head into the middle part of next week. In fact, by Tuesday, we'll see a mixture of clouds and sunshine, maybe a chance of a thunderstorm as well, with high temperatures getting up into the 60s. All right, my 3-degree guarantee for tomorrow is 55. If I can hit that high within 3 degrees, we will donate $100 to Compassionate Home Health Care. And unfortunately, we did not do that today. Here on the big debut of our new partner, Mother Nature had an April Fool's for me. I forecast 44. The actual high temperature was 48 degrees. And tonight we do want to introduce our next 3-degree guarantee partner. It's a nonprofit group called Compassionate Home Healthcare. The organization provides household essentials to people in the community. And leaders say right now there's a big need out there.
This campaign, we had been talking about this for the past week and a half. What can Compassionate do in these desperate times that some people go through? And this is right up our alley.
Typically, their biggest need is during the holidays, but this year they found that that time is actually right now. And not the best of starts for our new partnership, but it's not how you start, John, it's how you finish.
I have full faith that you'll go.